Welcome back, everybody. Drew and Rob here with our XRP robot. Now, in the last video, we assembled the robot and we connected it, made sure we could communicate with it. All that's good and done. Let's look at next steps. Now, right out in the front here, we've got a distance sensor, we've got a line following sensor, but neither of these are going to do us any good if the robot can't move. So I think the next step should be getting the motors running. What do you think, Drew?
That's an excellent point, Rob. In this video, we're going to take a look at how we make the robot drive around. Make the motors spin, get data from the encoders, and a gyroscope in order to make the robot drive accurately as well.
Excellent. Lead the way.
Can do.
that's really pretty simple. What is that, about a dozen lines of code? Python is not as terrifying as some people might think.
And you can see we have this ruler here to measure exactly how far it goes. That's precisely 27 meters.
Oh, one has to applaud that precision.
Something else that's really relevant for driving is knowing exactly the heading of the robot. The XRP includes an IMU with a gyroscope, which measures the rotation of the robot itself. To get that rotation, under the sensors section, click the gyro and then get the yaw, which is the same as the heading. What I'm going to do is actually add this to my previous print code. And so I'll re-enable that and disable my drive code. And then I will replace the motor position with that yaw block, and we are going to see what this prints out. And here we'll show the Python code for those who need that. Now we'll click the run button in the top right corner, just as always, and we'll see what values we get. Now you can see we're getting numbers printed out at the bottom, and if I turn the robot, you can see those values changing. In fact, if I turn the robot exactly 90 degrees, then that's exactly what the IMU tells us. Turn it back, we go back to zero. You'll notice that positive rotation is actually towards the left because of the right hand rule. Take your thumb up and rotate, that's positive. And then you can press the user button to stop the code like always. Now, just like we use the encoder to drive a specific distance, we can use the gyroscope to turn to a specific angle. And fortunately, we have another block for this. Under the drivetrain section, grab the turn block and put that in our code. Within here, we can specify the angle to turn in degrees and the amount of effort that it should use for turning. I don't need the print loop anymore, so I will drag this into the trash. And just like the straight block, the turn block prevents the code from continuing until it finishes, so we don't need to wait for the user button. We will show the Python code for this as well. And then we'll click the run button on the top right corner. And remember, the robot is going to move again, so just make sure it doesn't run away. And now we're going to see the robot turns exactly 90 degrees, just like we expected to. And run this again, because if I run it one more time, I'll emphasize the point. Is that it's using the gyroscope to measure the angle of the robot. So if it never actually turns, the code will never finish. That's actually right in here. Okay, so now I'm going to demonstrate one more thing. I'm going to re-enable this straight block and then connect these two to each other. This will make the robot drive forward 20 centimeters and then turn 90 degrees. Now, what do you think will happen if we do this four times? Let's find out. Under the loop section, I'm going to grab this repeat block and attach it right here. And then instead of repeating 10 times, I'm going to make it repeat four times. And I'm excited that I don't want the robot to start moving until I press the button, so I'm going to go into this control board and wait for button press, put that right before the loop. And now we're ready to run. We'll first show the Python code for last time. And then we'll click the run button. Now this will go into the robot, but it's not going to start moving yet because it's waiting for that button press. And now I'll unplug the robot, and as long as the power strip is still on, we'll keep running the same code. So we'll then take it over to the whiteboard and see what it does. Then I'll put the robot on the whiteboard, and when I press the user button, we'll start drawing. And as you can see, we made a square.
Okay, so that was really cool, and correct me if I'm wrong, but you could adjust the angles and the number of loops to create pretty much any polygon, yes?
Yeah, exactly. That would be a really cool challenge for anyone who wants to play around and see what they can do.
Cool, and you could use math, you could use distances to make all kinds of different shapes. I have an idea. Can I try one?
Yeah, go
for it. Okay, I'll be right back. What do you think? That shape represents the number of possibilities there are that you can draw with your XRP. Infinity.
That's pretty cool, Rob. I'm impressed.
Thanks. Think you can beat that one?
That's going to be tough. Yeah, I can do it. What do you think of that, Rob?
I bow to your superior artistic talents.
Thank you.
So there you go. You've learned how to operate the motors on your XRP. You've learned how to create shapes by changing the speed of each one. You've learned how to draw and design things. Now we want to see what you come up with, what shapes, what designs. We want you to share them with us and with the XRP community.
Yeah, we're really excited to see what you can make. Check the links down in the description for more resources on using XRP.
And until next time, happy hacking.
Happy roboting.
I'm like, he's getting awfully close.
That's a great point, Rob. Let's, in this, God, where's your heart? Yeah. I was caught off guard for you running away.
Okay.
You're good at that.